传说之外，龙可以是代表皇帝。啊、以前皇帝啊，有人喊他千岁万岁啊。而龙皇帝的衣服也是有龙的吗？嗯嗯嗯、啊。
Tobyato is sort of my artist moniker, which means Toby's art in Japanese. So it is, as my Instagram handle would say, right, it's a mess slash collection of my work. And I think that sort of embodies my journey so far. More recently, I had some brand collaborations in terms of creating products with brands, creating some wearables and things that people can sort of buy and own. So for me, art style is something that I build up over time. And then as the projects go along, I started to realize that unconsciously I delved into and I tapped into my own Chinese heritage. That was because it's something very familiar to me and what I grew up seeing. From my point of view, I think motifs sort of make up my artwork. So they are sort of icons and graphics that make up a composition. And I think going back to Chinese traditional arts, which is where I draw a lot of inspiration from, I think motifs like dragons, tigers, and phoenixes are very iconic motifs that are prevalent in the past and even still very prevalent now. In terms of motifs, how they were before and how they are seen now, I think there's definitely a lot of difference, but I think the main difference is context and the environment that they are put in. Motifs are still traditional, but it has been removed from the context that they used to be in. I think there's definitely some difference between how people from Eastern cultures and Western cultures view motifs, right? When we talk about dragons in like Western cultures, the first thing you think of is like Game of Thrones, right? There's like fire and everything. So like destruction and carnage sort of links to that in a certain way. Whereas in the Eastern context, when we bring up dragons, it's always symbolizes power. In the past, emperors used to wear like golden dragon silk robes and stuff like that. And it's seen outside temples and revered. Then I think that difference sort of permeates through different motifs as well. But personally, I would tap into more on the Eastern side of things that's more familiar to me. There's only so much you can research online, right? And it's hard to see what's credible and what's not and sort of get numb to it. I think having a chance to learn from someone that has generations of knowledge passed down to them is definitely quite a rare and exciting opportunity for me.
你几岁开始了？十几岁就开始了。十几岁就开始了。是你爸爸教你吗？还是？好了啊，他们教我。他是这样教的，也是这样教吗？啊，这样教哈，好像以前有学徒吗？
他说哦，你说你爸爸是有学徒的，哦，跟着他就要画画画，中国东西很多很多嘛，在里面讲不管他中国的文化，想不完哦，因为这种啊越来越好像生意会比较熟啊，比较冷门了啦。哦，以前有大是有什么还可以，
有些东西也是跟现在比起来也不一样啊。
啊，不一样哦，时代不一样了，全部做法也不一样了。
对了，
因为我们有做那个人家企业嘛。
前面不是有种胭脂咯，
他前面有翻个牌了吗？以前我们做很多。
那种很多啦，
做很多。这些的也有啦，拜神东西也有啦，差不多每天都有的做啦。到现在就越来越少了。因为现在已经改变很厉害了嘛，不像以前是吧？我们画的东西是要比较传统的文化这样啊，也是有想要创新画创新的东西啊。 或者是我们的年纪比较大了，就比较没有这个机会给我们有创新的、想象力来画它了。现在比较新的作品，这些衣服之类还是有啦。还有看你的外面市场嘛，市场的用法也要看嘛。啊，衣服这个随便每个人都可以买嘛，买一件好看不好看，那也有办法买嘛。然后你要做真的是用做衣服真正好的话，就没有这样容易做。
因为你要很多东西在里面啊，你的想法、看法、画法啊，不管是新款也好，旧款的画法都有，都有他们困难的问题啊，难度在里面。哇，以前你大多是画什么东西比较多？哦，以前小时候是画卡通咯，但大学毕业过后我就画比较多壁画咯。公司要跟我们设计什么东西，我比如他们手表之类、靴子这样。 这类咯，哇，你们是打稿打好在那边画呢？啊，对对对，一样咯，也是跟你差不多一样咯，也是打稿先，然后打稿用铅笔还是用那个 chalk， 然后再画上去咯。为什么很多中文的艺术这些作品都很多龙啊？因为龙就代表一个比较好像是又慈祥又稳重一样的动物来的吗？还会代表好运这些啊，好运啊，福气，全部都有啦。
啊，全部都有啦。
华文很喜欢的嘛，龙。对了对了，鱼跳龙门的意思是什么呢？
鱼鱼跳龙门是代表，这个是吉祥的东西。吉祥的东西啊，大河啊，跳过它变成啊，我变成一个龙头吧，鱼身鱼还是鱼的身体啦。啊，龙门。
之类的，通常龙也是会黄色吗？金色的。蓝色、金色也有，龙本身哈是一个吉祥龙，火和水哈，是人们他们本身它身体里面就有的。哦。龙有喷水的吗？嗯嗯嗯。啊，它旱边角有火有什么吗？哦。啊，以前你也听过它的故事啊。对对，龙本身它是会喷水的。嗯。以前有旱灾有什么，它龙会出来吗？它看到旱灾就在它上面喷水啊，喷水给他们。
东西全部会活吗？没有，它会干裂嘛。人民也辛苦嘛，做他的东西。那个农民啦。
啊啊，这种农田农民也辛苦嘛。所以他们不是很喜欢龙出来吗？对对对。啊，龙也会喷水。明白。那现在龙跟那些海这些呢？海是好像听说以前是龙就住在海里面嘛，东海龙王啊，西海龙王，几个龙王住在一起啊。那这个是个传说啦，我们也不用讲。
是吧？我们也没有看到，也知道，也是啊，是一个看他一个传说这样传下来了。配音这东西是看我们个人啊，没有讲一定要配啊，没有对错啊。所以如果这样，衣服这些龙这些还会保留下去，还保留嘛？他们做法不一样嘛？对对对，做法也许不一样，可是龙还是会保留啦，还保留。明白。Just fresh out of painting with him. One of the main thoughts that's still in my mind is that a lot of the things that he said and the things that he does echoes a lot of the way I feel about art as well, in terms of how practical it is, in terms of how he views things and how he approaches things. So things he says like, 画一天走一天, right? So like, paint one day, then you go to the next, right? So it's sort of just getting by. And he also said like, 做这个就是不是为了钱, right? So you're not doing this for money. I think a lot of craftsmen in Singapore and in other countries are well aware of the fact that the craft itself is going to morbidly be gone with them. Right? As much as the younger generation are interested to learn it, I think a lot of things might be too far gone. But he's also aware of the fact that because of these motifs are used in pop culture, in street culture, after showing him the references, he did also say that these motifs being used in a new context preserves them in their own way. If these motifs are preserved, the tradition, the stories and all the meanings that come with them will be preserved as well, because it is still relevant. But to get the sentiment from someone like him, with his wealth of experience and knowledge, it is quite a refreshing take, because that's something that I would definitely not figure out on my own. I'll just be like, oh, I need to learn, I need to preserve everything as a whole, right? Everything needs to be preserved. You cannot remove it from the equation, but then now removing it from the equation actually helps preserve something that might be lost if you try to preserve it as it is.